Stay on the ground! Do not move! Do you understand?
Timothy Williams understood. In Monroe, Louisiana, he dropped to the ground and put his hands behind his back. And still, there was this.
No.
Yes, that was a police officer who kicked him in the head.
1030.
We got
it.
Got
it.
Stand by.
Even as Williams cried out and was handcuffed, the abuse and humiliation from the white cops continued.
Stop!
Put your fucking hand behind your back.
We're over here by Rocky's Bar.
Williams recently filed a lawsuit charging police with excessive force. An internal investigation prompted police to fire Officer Jared Desadier. And because of the kick caught on body camera, Desadier has been charged with second-degree battery. However, amidst allegations, the Monroe, Louisiana Police Department routinely abused black prisoners in custody and then tried to cover it up, the entire department is now facing an FBI investigation. Hello, everybody. I'm David Schuster. Thanks for joining us. This particular incident happened in April of 2020. According to police reports, the Monroe, Louisiana cops were investigating an audible car or house alarm when they stopped Williams. Police say Williams voluntarily produced a plastic fake handgun he had hidden under his shirt. When the officer searched him for other weapons, the police report said a crack pipe fell from Williams' pocket. Williams says he was surrounded by 7 to 8 officers and ran because he was afraid. He says he realized he couldn't keep running and surrendered by putting his hands in the air. Then he laid on his stomach to be handcuffed. Quote, "I was just thinking maybe when I give up, they'll just put the handcuffs on me and I'll just face the charges they're going to charge me with. I didn't think I would be put in handcuffs and get beaten." The initial arrest report says Williams was taken to a local hospital for lacerations he suffered, quote, "while trying to evade capture." Yes, in their arrest report, police said his cuts and bruises came while he was trying to run from them and not after he had already surrendered. Furthermore, the report said nothing about how police handled him after he was on the ground. In other words, the cops tried to cover up their abuse. After a few hours in the hospital, police took Williams to a county jail. For weeks, Williams alleges he was denied medication and not allowed to make any phone calls. 3 months later, Williams pleaded guilty to flight from an officer and possession of drug paraphernalia. A judge released Williams on time served. A pastor then urged Williams to get an attorney and file a complaint. Only then did police conduct an internal review. According to that review, several officers had questioned each other the night of the arrest about whether their body cameras had been on. It underscores that right from the start, the police were worried they had done something unlawful that might have been recorded. The department review of all of this prompted the firing and charges against that one officer, Jared Desadier. The video showed him not only kicking Williams in the head, but also placing his knee on Williams' neck for several minutes. 4 other officers involved in Williams' arrest were placed on administrative leave. Williams' lawsuit alleges the police department attempted a wide-ranging cover-up and has a pattern of mistreating and abusing prisoners. The FBI says it is also reviewing this case and trying to determine whether a formal Justice Department review should be launched. It is reassuring that the key officer involved has already been fired and faces criminal charges. However, without the body camera video, one wonders if any of this would have ever come to light. Once again, we have another incident of white police officers horribly mistreating a black suspect. And you wonder why anybody would run from police to begin with. The local law enforcement system in the United States needs an overhaul. This stuff is outrageous.